Good morning everyone, myself Saurabh Kumar Mathur. Today I got an opportunity to speak on the topic India's energy crisis and ways to resolve it. Energy does not mean only oil or petrol but all the conventional and non-conventional energy. Conventional source of energy: thermal power plant, hydropower plant, biomass, biogas, charcoal, wind energy. Non-conventional source of energy: solar energy, tidal energy, wave energy, thermal energy, geothermal energy, nuclear energy. Energy crisis does not mean the scarcity of energy. The meaning of energy crisis is the problem of production and distribution for any region. Energy crisis equal to demand of energy greater than supply of energy. What causes energy crisis? Demand side, supply side. Demand side: overconsumption due to energy efficiencies. In India's consumption of energy is 3 times more than the developed countries for the same quantity production. Overpopulation: the rise of the middle and high class people increases the energy demand. Due to climate change, more energy is needed for cooling and warming of homes. Supply side: political crisis in OPEC countries. US sanctions on Iran, Russia and Venezuela. The cartel of OPEC countries. Overexploitation of resources leads to loss of resources. Electricity is critical to fuel the economic growth of India. The country is on the fast trajectory of development, but to keep the momentum of growth high, availability of uninterrupted power supply is a must. India needs electricity to fuel the growth of even industries, be it large scale or small scale, manufacturing, healthcare or education. There are many roadblocks in unleashing the full potential of India's power sector. One is fuel availability concern faced by the industry. Coal supply by Coal India Limited is restricted to around 65% of actual coal requirement by coal-based thermal plants, leading to increased dependence on imported coal. This results in increasing power generated cost due to limited fuel availability. Increasing operational inefficiencies and outstanding debts have led to poor financial health of state DISCOMs. Then there are other concerns such as land acquisition, which has made purchase of land for power projects very expensive. Installation of power plants in any case requires huge investment, and the land acquisition cost pushes the capex to unprofitable, unsustainable development. India has been dependent to a large extent on energy imports to meet its energy requirement. As per the estimates of Planning Commission, Government of India, to ensure a sustained 8% growth of economy by 2031 to 2032, India needs to increase its primary energy supply by 3 to 4 times and its electricity generation by 5 to 6 times of the 2003 to 2004 levels. To limit the dependency on energy imports and contribute in meeting this energy challenge, the government is also laying a lot of emphasis on energy efficiency and demand side management. Efforts are being made to increase supply for renewable source of energy and promote energy conservation with various consumption sectors through appropriate policy intervention. Solution needed for a better society. Energy alternative. There is need for alternate energy which will not only offset the demand conventional fossil fuel but also pave way to cleaner solution. A green growth economy is the need of the hour. Ironically, India has world's 5th largest coal reserve and still faces acute power crisis. India's per capita power sector consumption, around 940 kilowatt hour, is among the lowest in the world. In comparison, China has a per capita consumption of 4000 kilowatt hour, with the developed countries averaging around 15000 kilowatt hour of per capita consumption. But the good news is that a massive overhaul of the power sector is underway, with the government planning to bring in a series of amendments. For instance, there will be changes to the Electricity Act of 2003 across all segments of the power value chain within the current session of parliament. The Union Cabinet in November approved the launch of Din Dayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana for ensuring 24/7 power supply. The facilitated judicious fostering of supply to agriculture and non-agriculture consumers in rural areas and strengthened the sub-transmission and distribution infrastructure in rural areas, including metering of distribution transformer feeders or consumers. Progress of independent power project has recently accelerated. The 700 megawatt Enron project at Dabhol is under construction, and two power projects have actually started generating power. The 235 megawatt GBK project at Jagarupura in Andhra Pradesh and 208 megawatt spectrum project at Kakinada in Andhra Pradesh. India is currently facing energy crisis with a major dependence on coal, crude oil imports to meet sharply growing energy needs to the country. More than 40% household lacks access to electricity. There is need for alternate energy which will not only offset the demand of conventional fossil fuel but also pave way to cleaner solution with less poisonous gases emission. Thank you and have a very nice day.